up against the Windranger mid, it's kind of a wash of a matchup. You can't really lane dominate, but the Queen of Pain can lane dominate. You can get rid of the offlaner by yourself, more or less, kind of like a gyrocopter. And more importantly, you get those free levels, that free farm, and a hero like Alchemist, you know, you'll be able to trade farm fairly effectively no matter what. Because this hero doesn't need the same level of farm to really be on equal footing. You're almost always going to be ahead just because of the bounty rune.
So starting things here in our first game, looks like Virtus Pro are going to be heading on down to that bottom bounty rune. Vici Gaming not going to contest. A little bit surprised that Virtus Pro aren't maybe trying to make some sort of sneaky maneuvers and try and fight over that first bounty rune in order to deny it away from the Alchemist, which is usually the play by these teams. But Virtus Pro perhaps a little bit scared of the early aggression of heroes like Undying.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to fight into Undying plus Arctic Burn and the Slardar stun. Mm-hmm. That's a pretty easy recipe for losing the fight. You do have some heroes that at level 1 are okay, but why even risk it?
DK Phobos. Unlikely to challenge here. Looks like Super will get that first bounty rune. Ice in the other end is going to go and try and take that bounty rune, and he gets it successfully. Okay. The question is whether or not he's going to be able to get away with that.
They're
one unscathed. He's going to be able to get a real good body block with a shackle over the top, and Illidan looks like he will be the one to claim the first blood. No, it's going to be G taking that last hit instead. But nice choice by God. Split second there, choosing to level up Shackle Shot, allowing the Gyrocopter to have time in order to get there for the Rocket Barrage. Able to take that first blood.
Yeah, and he's going to get harassed pretty heavily, but this mid lane, ooh, FNG decides to try to go for the courier. Isn't quite there, though.
Nice. He gets a lot of damage there on Super off of the Shadow Wave, obviously. The courier snipe would have been the best deal, but G takes a lot of damage from the early aggression of FY. Pretty standard for Winter Wyverns in that middle lane.
Yeah, and he didn't level the win run because he was trying to get that first blood, and even though Ice, this is going to help him. It kind of resets everything in the mid lane because G just got the first blood. That's even more favorable than getting the bounty rune, unless you're the Alchemist. But something I would like to highlight is just the fact that you don't necessarily have to, you know, try lane in your safe lane just because Burning is going to be given such a favorable 1v1 matchup. And this is going to allow Vici Gaming to run some pretty aggressive dual lanes here.
And also be stacking up for the Alchemist, as we could already see that medium and hard camp are attempted to be stacked up by the Winter Wyvern, which I believe this is why FNG does lay out some aggressive wards, trying to get vision of the rotations of FY.
Yeah, precisely, and this is why they decided to lane the way they did. The Queen of Pain, you don't necessarily need her in the mid lane when you can just decide to do these dual lanes, but... And the Spiritbreaker is doing quite well for himself. He's got 3 CS, he's almost level 3, he's got that crucial level of bash, and he's gonna get harassed at top, but... He's gonna charge away.
Simply charge out. Meanwhile, the bottom lane, Ice, and Fenrir are attempting to steal this pull. And they're gonna start going on to FNG. He obviously has enough space to be able to stay ahead of both his Undying and Slardar, while DK Phobos cancels his charge in the middle lane. Will sit on the bounty rune, pick that one up, while the regen is picked up by Ice's Slardar.
For me, this feels like such an important match for VP especially, because they seem to have this monkey on their back where they're at the cusp. They're like the gatekeeper for tier 1 teams.
Mm-hmm.
If you beat them, you're a tier 1 team. If you can't beat them, you stay in that tier 2 region. And I really feel like this is something that they need to get the ball rolling, because oftentimes you'll see them get so close, for example, in the group stage where they were able to take a game off EG, but they just weren't able to close out the series.
Right. I mean, the story of Virtus Pro has been 5th through 6th, tournament after tournament after tournament, which is a decent showing, but not good enough to be considered champions.
Yeah, definitely. And VG Gaming on the flip side, consecutive top 3 finishes at TI, if I remember correctly. So this is a team that's really used to winning at this point. Or actually, they got fourth at the most recent one. So third at the previous TI and fourth at TI5. So they're in a much better situation as a team.
Fenrir has been left alone at this bottom lane while Ice goes scouting away. He does have the boots set up, and with a potential extra level in Crush, he could go for maybe a wraparound in the middle lane. We'll see him actually running into the Courier here. But he's still going to try and go for the kill onto G. Super doesn't have a level on Stable Concoction, so I'm not sure if Ice can really get this one essentially by himself.
Yeah, and G's actually not standing in the Acid Cloud, so... Even though the Slithering Crush is physical damage, it shouldn't be able to do enough there. Without the stun, this is pretty typical. But Ice might just be making the rotation in.
Once
so
again,
super can farm.
DK Phobos is going to charge away from the attempted go by both FY and Burning.
Yeah, both offlaners are actually being shut out pretty hard. And CS Advantage does go the way of Vici, which is a little bit surprising.
Super gets a bit lucky, will be able to find himself a bounty rune. I believe that's why Ice is kind of rotating around now, as it is all important to make sure that Alchemist has a strong laning phase and is able to get those bounty runes.
That's so weird that we consider that lucky. For any other hero, you just say, I don't want that rune.
Oh my god,
two bashes in a row!
Is he actually going to be able to get another bash? Not in time. DK Phobos, though, puts a serious hurting. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, Ice comes forward, challenging G and forcing him back away from Super.
Yeah, that can't be how that hero is meant to work. Just bash twice in a row and almost get a kill by yourself.
Oh man, what a big upset that would have been. They're trying to make sure that Super can get his level 6 and he'll have a little bit of individual sustain. He's only halfway there though.
You don't really need too much help for Super though. He has the Soul Ring. He opted to forgo the bottle and just go for the straight for the Soul Ring.
Mm-hmm.
And it's better HP regen. I still like the bottle though, but I guess if Burning has one, you don't want to crowd the runes a little bit too much. And with the amount of stacks that he has, this might actually be better.
Yeah, spending time in the jungle in order to pick up your level 6 rather than risking it against especially heroes like a Spirit Breaker, staying low in that middle lane may not be the best idea.
And I do like that Ice is rotated around so much, because he can't really do anything about this.
But even bigger rotation coming out from Virtus Pro, they're actually going to smoke up with Illidan.
Oh, if they could kill...
They're going to ult on this stack, and they're not going to be able to get Super, he's just barely outside of that ultimate, but they'll take the full stack, and I'm sure Illidan, he would have loved to kill the Alchemist, but I'm sure they'll be happy with this as long as he gets out. Now, he does have the Dazzle help him out a little bit, and the healing cell to bring him back up to full.
The timing for that, if he was just 1 second later, of course he has no idea and he's got no vision.
Mm-hmm.
But Super also had no idea that he was there and he was going to run into a cooldown. And he was just outside the lip of it. But they are going to steal up all the stacks, and this is actually really significant because now Super has to rotate back to the mid lane. Fenrir doesn't really have a place to level, and that was a lot of time wasted by the Winter Wyvern. And that could have been time that she used to zone out the offlaner, help out her mid.
The ward setup, the aggressive wards by BP, they knew it preemptively, actually had a counter ward ready to go. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Lil is actually going to be dying here, chased down by FY and Ice. So as they rotate the gyrocopter out of that bottom lane, it leaves the support open to diving.
Yeah, that was really well played by Vici Gaming. Once FY picks up that Invis rune, definitely wants to set it up because Ice is probably falling a little bit further behind than they would like. Because in a lineup like this, he really needs to be the main initiator. You don't want your Queen of Pain to play the instant blink jump in hero. You want her to kind of play like CTY did yesterday, where you bait your teammates out a little, scout the landscape, and see if it's a really favorable fight.
They are stopping any further. Well, as I say that, Fenrir actually uses a decay in order to stack up the hard camp once again, but Virtus Pro does have vision of that, and I believe they also saw the ward laid down by Vici Gaming. They should have anyway.
And if you're Virtus Pro, you want to try to get aggressive in the mid game with the setup once your Visage hits that crucial level 6 with the birds. And I don't know if it's hyperbole to say that Lil is probably the best Visage in the world, maybe.
Oh, I wouldn't
it
say
seems
that's
like
hyperbole
he's,
at all.
Yeah, I feel like he's one of the few that still continue to play the hero. And this is why Virtus Pro continue to draft it, even if it hasn't been in vogue. But they're going to go for this mid lane gank, and the Shackle connects.
And now the Gyrocopter Ultimate is going to go out, slowing down Super with the Power Shot. They easily clean up that Alchemist, and Virtus Pro are setting a tempo here that is keeping the Alchemist utterly shut out.
Yeah, but something that they have to worry about is that Burning continues to get free farm in this offlane, or in this safe lane right now, and the Spirit Breaker isn't quite level 6. And the Slaughter at bottom, because they've had to rotate so often, is being given essentially a free lane. And this is not something you want to do for a player like Ice especially, but you've really got no choice. When you're playing with the Gyrocopter, you want to rotate this hero as much as possible, just because he's so strong at this phase of the game.
Yeah, and it leaves a spot open for a greedy 4 position like the Visage in order to get that early level 6 that allows him to be able to have a much larger impact in the game, whether it's split pushing or fighting.
The problem though is they're going to play so aggressively on the other side of the jungle that they don't actually have ward vision for Lil here at bottom, so he's constantly playing back and he's starting to get a little bit cocky here, and this might just
He starts putting some pressure onto Ice, but as we say that, Fenrir's going to come in, already has the tombstone. Ice drop it a bit low, and I think Lil just wants to make the commitment here for this kill. Does get the double drop, gets out the nuke, and takes out the Slaughter, and he's still looking plenty healthy. They're going to address the tombstone now, but a Shackle Shot comes in, locks down Fenrir. They'll get that kill as well. G is on a killing spree. Virtus Pro respond at the perfect time in order to stop that gank on Lil.
Really, it just looked like Lil wasn't even being ganked. He's like, I'm just going to solo kill the Slardar right now. I don't really care that the Undying's here. Perfect bird control. They're able to mop up some kills. They've always got to worry about burning as he continues to farm. He's got 56 CS already. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Gaming, this isn't the pace that they wanted to set.
With this much early farm, what do you build on Queen of Pain? Do you go for that Aghanim's Ult statting up a little bit and just continuing your farm via that 30-second, 40-second Sonic Wave? Or do you go a little bit more aggressive with the Orchid and start hunting down heroes?
I feel like the Orchid's really good against some heroes on Virtus Pro, but it's pretty bad. For example, it won't do too much when the Spirit Breaker charges at you and hits you.
Mm-hmm.
And the Visage Birds, you need some amount of HP for control, but it's so common nowadays just to get it for the physical damage. And it builds so nicely, right? You go for the Orchid for your physical damage, you round it out with a BKB as your defensive item, and then you've got your Assault Curse just to help out your team overall.
Yeah, when you have amplified damage on top of everything else, the Queen of Pain is actually hitting like a real carry. G, gonna head up to the top rune. Bounty rune will be snagged by Super, though. And already up to 3k. But this is going to be a slower Radiance than you normally expect out of your mid-Alchemist because Virtus Pro has been putting so much pressure there.
Yeah, the fact that he's only 200 net worth above the Windranger is pretty surprising. And this goes, like you said, just to show how much Virtus Pro have been able to do to slow him down. They took his stacks, they made a dedicated effort to gank him in the mid lane. And slowing him down is definitely going to be crucial to their strategy. Is they want to try to get aggressive, start playing the objectives at any point.
DK Phobos does have his completed urn and level 6 ready to go, so he can be a factor here in maybe gaining a quick pick off for VP, but right now they seem more concerned to just farming up and perhaps making up for a lot of the time that they spent in the enemy jungle. You need to still get that Gyrocopter's basic amount of farm.
Alright, so the Gyrocopter, despite the fact that he's actually gone around roaming, he's kind of kept up in net worth. I know he's 500 behind the Queen of Pain, but he's provided so much for his team, and this is something that you sort of expect. Like, Gyrocopter is not the traditional one carry that you'll see. You're generally going to be the hero that rotates around for your team, so that, like you said, you can open up the 4 position role for Lil. And he's actually going to be more like a core hero this game. And this is how Virtus Pro almost always run it, where Lil is just going to get an exclusive amount of farm. You build him so that he can pretty much solo burst any hero by himself with just the medallion.
I love this. Look at this gank coming out. The smoke goes out. They're going to be able to hit Burning with the ultimate first. Follow up with the birds. And that is a beautiful setup by Virtus Pro. Lil lending his familiars up to that top lane gank does manage to get a critical kill on Burning.
And that's something else that we haven't really talked about, is the global presence of the birds at all time. And when you've got a hero that, or a player that can control it like that, it makes it so difficult. You get caught out unaware so quickly.
I think the best part of that smoke as well is the fact that it allowed DK Phobos close enough to just throw out Nether Strike, right? And he didn't have to try and lead in with the charge, and the Queen of Pain would get some distance back to that tier 1 tower.
Yeah, and despite getting that much, Super still has a pretty healthy amount of farm. He's going to pick up the 12-minute Radiance, and we are talking a lot about what VP are able to do, but this lineup doesn't really come online until Super grabs that Radiance.
Yeah, I was almost expecting Virtus Pro to go for like this rinse and repeat every few minutes, go into the enemy jungle, but I guess they feel like they shut down the Alchemist enough that they can go ahead and focus on their own farm and maybe, you know, shutting down some of those other heroes like Burning.
Yeah, and they're going to try to get aggressive into the enemy jungle. This is what you want to do as the Dire. Don't give the 3 utmost right camps up for free. And that's why VP, they're just farming on the left side, and Lil's just completely playing by his tower because everybody's missing on the map. And this is readily apparent that they've gone for the smoke just because nobody's defending this mid lane right now. And nobody's punishing FNG at top.
Lil's gonna run into him. FY will be able to slow down Lil a bit. Burning comes forward, but with the extra movement speed coming out from that Grave Chill, Lil will be perfectly fine.
I'm actually surprised that they didn't just Winter's Curse and blow him up with maybe one or two abilities. They potentially thought there was more heroes there at bottom, but
yeah,
it's actually the rotation at top.
They've been missing for quite a long time, and maybe that's why they didn't want to use Winter's Curse and Sonic Wave, because what if the Dazzle, right, was behind that Visage, and all of a sudden the Gyrocopter comes in, you've expended everything for a hero you didn't actually kill, and VP can make the turnaround. The truth is, though, VP are actually moving into the enemy jungle once again, as FNG was signaling that for a few minutes now.
Yeah, it's easy from our perspective to just say, because we have perfect vision, obviously, that they could have made the rotation down and killed them instantly.
Mm-hmm.
But if it was a smoke ink, you might just lose the game right there. Because right after that, they would have the Medallion on the Visage, they probably go for the Roshan, and they take so much map control as a result. But there are a lot of wards in the Radiant jungle, as we see. And you want to try to get aggressive with these as much as possible.
Got the charge on Super, as well as the ultimate from the Spearbreaker. Slowed down by the Gyrocopter ult, and G will take it yet another snipe at those kills.
Yeah, 6-1 in 14 minutes, and he goes for the Shackle a little bit too far, but this should mean the mid tower for VP, as they're going to swarm around. And VG Gaming, I don't even really think they have enough to quickly push down this tower. VP might have enough time to respond.
G catches two Queen of Pains, Wolf of Illusions, obviously. VG Gaming will be able to take that bottom tier 1 tower, looks like. Before VP rotate, they did have a glyph, but they're going to pop it now. It doesn't look like they had enough TPs or mana on some of these heroes. DK Phobos doesn't have a TP, Windranger has no mana for once, so they're just going to keep going, pressure the tier 2. Short distance at the middle lane does allow VP to just kind of keep going before VG Gaming can rotate.
Yeah, and something pretty interesting is that the Gyrocopter opted not to go for the stacks. And I think it's just because it takes quite a while to do those ancient stacks at this phase of the game when all you have is the Helm of Dominator. He's actually just using it to roam around with him to give him max mobility. And I believe that Aura, yeah, it helps your team out too. And when you've got a team that just essentially wants to continue running, it's sort of like drums in a roundabout way, minus the stats.
Yeah, it is a pretty interesting idea. The some of the slows of VG Gaming are going to be counteracted, perhaps, by this Kobold. And obviously, you want to stay ahead of this Alchemist and Slardar as much as you can. Ice does have a Blink Dagger, so that's going to be a bit of a challenge for VP to void him. Lays down another aggressive ward. VG Gaming, they're just counteracting aggression with aggression of their own, essentially. Every single time VP make that engagement into the enemy jungle, VG Gaming do something similar and lay out the wards necessary to perhaps find a pick off later on.
Yeah, VP, if you're VP, you've got to clear out your jungle or the wards as much as you possibly can, just to make sure that you're not being scouted out, that one of your heroes don't just get two or three men smoking. Because that can lead to something like an early Roshan for VG.
Mm-hmm.
They still have the Slardar, and this is what they're going to do. Try to find a pick off, maybe even open up Roshan if they can go for this.
Well, FNG, he'll tank the gank, and that probably opens up the fact that there is some sort of ward in their jungle. But still, that was a 3 or 4 man smoke from VG Gaming, only catching out a Dazzle. VP are going to be okay with that as long as they don't lose more. TK Phobos charging in, but can't quite go in just yet. The rest of his team not ready to go.
Yeah, there's almost no chance that he goes for that at that point. The Dazzle is still dead, and this is a pretty crucial hero for their lineup. But VG Gaming, they're just playing around this area. Burning's gonna now TP to the top lane, push it out a little bit, force some pressure. And maybe if they're fast enough, you can open up the map a little bit more. So Burning goes here at top, you force a TP rotation.
Push out in middle lane, TK Phobos charging through, but that does get pinged out by VG Gaming. So you can already see Burning is quick on the retreat there. It's going to be going for the Orchid build. We'll see how that fares for him, because he can just easily be blown up by that Spirit Breaker. But as we were talking about, that Silence is still going to be useful against VP, and obviously the physical damage in conjunction with the Amp will work out pretty nicely for Burning. Ice jumping forward here, trying to put some pressure onto Illidan. VP do respond with a TP out from DK Phobos, which is revealed thanks to that vision from Amplify Damage.
Yeah, and this is so important for VP that they were able to take down the enemy mid tower and they were able to save their own, because it allows them to continue to protect their jungle. And I've been stressing this a lot in our cast lately, but I just feel like being able to save your Radiant jungle just allows you to continue to get ahead. And it makes it really difficult for Dire to play aggressively like this. If they decide to show three heroes mid on the side of VG Gaming, but they can't really do anything, because the potential for a 5-man is so fast for VP.
Burning? Oh, okay. Missed out on that one. Burning had a free deny in that top tier 1 tower, but doesn't see it in time. And that'll be another tower going to Virtus Pro.
Yeah, he probably just kind of was thinking of other things, looking around.
Yeah.
But VP, they're going to get aggressive here. No reason not to is...
Nice.
This is where you're going to be the strongest.
Some of these laning wards, I think, are sometimes hard to actually find, but VG Gaming does manage to run into him. Nice blink back there from Ice running into the smoke of VP.
It's so hard to go up without vision there. But VG Gaming, they might just decide to go for a smoke of their own immediately after. And this is such an odd time because VP were actually the ones playing aggressively.
Oh, they saw the charge. ZK is actually running into the smoke. Now the ultimate goes out for the gyrocopter. They have the Winter's Curse locking down Illidan. And Burning's going to come forward. Blows out the Sonic Wave as well. Do they have the heal? Oh, no. FNG's not here in time. DK Bubble is going to be the next target. Lil comes forward, trying to go for Ice, but a Cold Embrace will help save the Slardar. Nice Shackle Shot, preventing VG Gaming from keep on going forward. Ice does his Blink Dagger up. He's going to go for Lil. Locks him inside of the trees. Burning jumps on top of him as well. Shallgrave will be able to buy him some time. That's why Super throws that stun over to FNG instead. The Shackle Shot doesn't last this time around, but Fenrir almost gets blown up. Unfortunately, another good Cold Embrace from FY does save yet another ally. Virtus Pro stumble into just the wrong team fight as they trade 1-4.
That was so intelligent by VG Gaming, the way that they set that up. The smoke fails from VP, so they immediately gather up as four because FNG has shown himself at top. And that was supposed to be the bait for VP. You show FNG at top, they don't naturally assume that you're going to go for your own gank. So VG Gaming know that at the very least, that's a 4v5 fight. And because FNG had a TP to that top lane, there's almost no way that they're going to win that.
Now, unfortunately, VP had kept their middle tier 1 tower healthy enough that VG Gaming wasn't able to push it in one go. With the glyph and the TPs in, they do force VG Gaming back and manage to get the deny. But VG Gaming, obviously, in a very good place with the Alchemist making a sizable recovery. DK Phobos now going to run into Ice, but didn't have his Nether Strike up just yet. So couldn't really continue for that.
Yeah, and you notice that VG Gaming, they continue to try to take control of this jungle right now, and this is helping them so much because every time they're spotting the rotation out of the gyrocopter, and you can't just continue to buy smokes. You have to eventually save one or two of them for the Roshan attempts or more important objectives. And I think that's what that mid smoke was for. But unfortunately, they ran into the wrong target.
VP, luckily, do find one of those wards deep inside their jungle, but there's still this other one by the rune area that VP actually unknowingly copied not so long ago. FNG lays out another ward by the Roshan pit. That's obviously what we're going to be looking at next with the minus armor synergy of the Alchemist and the Slardar. VG Gaming could do it rather easily. But VP do have the Wind Ranger, Ice. Well, his Blink Dagger was being canceled out there by the urn, but DK Phobos choose not to go for that kill.
Yeah, and their ability to keep up this tier 1 bottom tower for VG Gaming is continuously allowing them the split push cap. Because if they didn't have it, then Burning might have to be there a little bit sooner.
Right.
But because they've constantly been able to keep it up, he can just continue to play the farm game.
Ice. I love the way he's playing this. Just so aggressively in the face of VP, giving them a taste. Hey, look at me. Come for me. Try and catch me. But he's always able to get back in time via the Blink Dagger and the sprint.
Yeah. And this is so frustrating for VP because they're so committed to this bottom tower, but look at what the rest of VG Gaming are doing. Like, mm-hmm. The two cores are farming in the jungle because they have that tower available. So it's almost like they're challenging them. Ice is, like you're saying, presenting himself as a target and saying, okay, if you go for me, the instant TP rotation is going to come around and we will win that fight.
Yeah, and as the analysts were talking about before, the Cold Embrace is actually critically important here against a lot of the VP members, whether it's the Spirit Breaker or the Wind Ranger's Focus Fire. It is a very decent counter to VP if they ever do manage to catch that Slardar. So
you just kind of have to make some sort of move or completely round out, because VP, they've wasted so much time in this bottom area,
mm-hmm.
continuously trying to take that tower or look for an opening, that they've actually given up more than a full 2 minutes of farm to these two cores, and this has allowed Burning to catch up in net worth. He's now only 400 behind the gyrocopter, and most importantly, this Alchemist, yeah, you're meant to be ahead, but 5,000 is still significant.
Absolutely. More time the VP led up, the more that net worth graph is going to go down. Nice spotted out there with the weave that will allow G to be able to land the Shackle Shot to continue the vision via the charge and get the quick pickoff that allows them to take control of this tier 1 tower. Question is, are they going to go for more? It may be at the cost of their top lane because Burning is already on top of that tier 1.
And this is the issue, is that you were able to get one hero and take one tower, but Burning is going to do nearly the exact same thing. And You might have been getting like slightly better of a trade when it comes to kills, but just overall farm definitely favors VG Gaming right now.
And Shackle Shot did come out, but the TP was a bit faster. They will be able to get another deny.
I think if you're VP now, you want to try to get aggressive. You just completed the BKB now on the gyrocopter. Start going around the map, claiming more objectives, because right now this passive style isn't going to benefit you in the long run, just because of how much more greedy VG Gaming are playing.
Yeah, Super is about to become the full Naga Siren. He's got the Radiance with the Travel Manta. Next up, it's going to be the Octarine Core. And they're actually going to try and take Roshan here, but Virtus Pro, they're going to be able to run into this one, but the initiation comes out from Ice Ice Ice. They're going to try and blow up Illidan first, but he gets off the BKB. Super turns around, two-man stun from that unstable concoction, and they will be able to get out. Winter's Curse down, laid on to Lil, trying to pop that hero, but Visage is still alive. Burning comes forward and finishes him off, but farther up, they get a Shackle Shot onto Slardar. Now they're going to be able to get FY as well. VG Gaming coming forward, nice charge from DK. Vobles pushes a couple back, but VP are actually going to try and make the retreat, and they're splintering off. DK Vobles is going to be the first one to TP out, and VG Gaming may be happy with this one. Might just look to take Roshan instead. Virtus Pro still hanging around, but they lost DK Phobos. He will be able to charge
into that Shackle.
That Shackle Shot comes in. Burning's going to be targeted, but an unstable concoction buys Burning time. He actually gets away with the blink, and God is going to be stunned up and goes for Fenrir instead. With that Midas armor, will be able to get that one kill. And Illidan, he actually found the Queen of Pain, able to take her out, and VG Gaming will be the ones to lose for this time.
That's constant bird control from Lil, too, is what's enabling them to win that fight, because he was so instrumental in disrupting the fight as much as possible. And
is that how they spotted out the Queen of Pain? Because she was stuck in the trees.
Yeah, he was just hitting him with the birds.
Nice.
He continues to play out that fight, and despite the advantage that it looked like VG Gaming had for a little bit, like they were fighting in a choke point.
Oh, Ice, the three-man stun! They're gonna go through it! The Midas armor with the stable concoction, and Super just takes him out in one hit! God, he's gonna start backing away, but the Shackle Shot's onto him, FY! He's gonna catch up as well, slowing down G! They're not gonna be able to get Roshan in time, or they will! Lil gets the agent, but it's a disaster! VP at boss three, and Lil may not even get out. Unstable concoction gonna be able to catch him next, and there just seems to be no hope for Lil in this coming life, too.
Yeah, he's definitely going to die here, and he was able to snatch the Aegis, which should slow down the aggression of VG Gaming after this huge fight.
Oh, but that's even worse! I didn't even notice that VG Gaming were the ones who got the kill on Roshan, so they at least get that bounty for themselves, even if the Aegis is negated.
Exactly. They were able to grab it with the Acid Cloud, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was the only thing that was in there. And that was pretty unfortunate for Virtus Pro, because for a second there, it looked like they had such a great fight, but everybody begins to respawn. The Alchemist comes in, completely messes up that fight.
BKB next up for Burning, so he will be able to play this a bit more aggressively as time goes on. Virtus Pro, seemed like a shining moment for them once they beat VG Gaming in the initial fight, the reinitiation by Ice's Lardar. Opens things up for VG Gaming to be able to still hold on to their significant advantage. In fact, the Alchemist is almost looking at double the net worth of both the Gyrocopter and the Windranger.
Yeah, and this is the power of both the Dire and the fact that the Slardar was the hero that died first on VG Gaming, is that they were able to get him out there so quickly right after. And I mean, Virtus Pro definitely didn't expect that. They probably thought that VG Gaming was going to be on the heels, but continuing to press forward. And Illidan at top, you've got to be careful. You do have the BKB, but they have Winter's Curse.
He's going to try and get away, pops the BKB, just hoping to be able to stay ahead of FY, and smartly just keeps running rather than trying to go for the TPO.
Still, I think that was your next BKB charge. That's the 8 second. And most importantly, the Alchemist has become sort of like the Naga Siren.
Yeah, full split push build is ready to go. You have every single 22 seconds illusions to throw out. You've got Chemical Rage, which barely has a downtime now, about 8 seconds. Ice is going to be picked off, it looks like, by DK Phobos. Good bird control once again for Lil, making sure that Ice has no rebuttal.
Yeah, but Super is the hero for me to watch continuously. Like, the fact that he's at 20k net worth at just 27 minutes in, even though you are the Alchemist, I stress this is still pretty farmed.
They will have their completed Aghanims coming in for a little. He just needs 100 gold. That's a sizable increase in physical damage and control against the Alchemist. If he can complete that Solar Crest and they have the Weave as well, there is a chance that VP can take out that huge net worth hero early on in a team fight by just focusing him down. But it just seems like for now, VG Gaming are always going to be able to have the better control of the map via Super. Unstable Concoction coming in, does manage to stun up too. FY, not go for the Winter's Curse, but he will be charged up. Now the Darkhunter ultimate gets laid out. Now the Winter's Curse laid out onto DK Bubbles with Sonic Wave over the top. It looks like Spirit Breaker will might be going down. Illusion's chasing him, but Illidan does take out the Tombstone first. Unstable Concoction landing on two once again. Super is nailing these ones. Meanwhile, Ice actually just stunning up God, making sure he can't get back into the fight. As Illidan definitely needs the help, but he's not going to get it in time. G comes in, will be able to take out Burning, but Super comes in with yet another Unstable Concoction. Slowing down, G does get the kill before DK Bobos can push him back out, and VP are going to fall one by one until VG Gaming have it all.
And that's a five-man wipe. This is so disastrous for VP, as they're just not scaling in items anymore. If you look at the Gyrocopter's farm, he has the BKB, he has the Helmet Dominator, but these are largely defensive items that won't really do anything for you when it comes to the damage department, and you need some damage right now, because if you saw, when they initiated on Super, G tries to use the Focus Fire on him, they just simply don't do enough damage at this phase.
Yeah, and he's going for the Chrysalis build, which is standard for Wind Rangers, but they are going to desperately need an MKB, I think, because the Solar Crest, now completed on the Undying, is just going to make this Alchemist even tougher to deal with.
Yeah, the problem right now is that the Gyrocopter is more tanky, but he doesn't do enough damage, and the Wind Ranger has the inverse problem where she does do a lot of damage, but she gets chased back so soon.
Things looking very good for VG Gaming as we stumbling onto that 30-minute marker, over 10k lead in both gold and experience for them right now.
When it comes to the XP graph, which is a little bit more reliable for me when you're playing against an Alchemist, This also matches up as they're ahead 10k in that department. And this is just because they've been able to keep up almost all their heroes whenever these team wipes happen.
Now, it seems pretty clear to me that Virtus Pro weren't able to take enough control. They're not going to be able to end this game early against the Alchemist. He's reached that full, as we keep saying, Naga Siren build, where he's just going to split push and maintain control. But what about the late game? Can Virtus Pro try and push this game 60 minutes? What do you think their chances are?
I think when it comes to the straight late game, it's still sort of okay, but the fact that they've got a hero that almost just one-on-one counters the Wind Ranger in FY with the Cold Embrace makes it so hard for them to kill the Alchemist in the first place. And this is going to be made even more difficult just because he finishes a full Assault Curse as soon as this fight ends. And we were talking about the fact that he was double the net worth of the Wind Ranger, but if you add up like nearly the next three heroes on the side of Virtus Pro, Super can almost match them.
Yeah, very insane. Super will get a little bit more gold in his pocket as he takes that tier 2 tower, and they have reached a serious peak, and they know it. They're going to push uphill immediately, not waiting for silly things like Roshan, who needs it when it seems like Super is going to be unkillable outright.
They're going to start TPing now, but it might have been a little bit too late as their tower stuff taking some damage. VG Gaming, they can kind of force this, but they could also just wait for the Roshan, get the Aegis onto Burning. The BKB is now completed on Burning, and that was such an awkward way for DK Phobos to end that charge.
Yeah, I think he realized that if they stuck around this cliff area, he could be found. He doesn't want to get caught here and force his allies to try and come up that staircase. Too dangerous. VG Gaming are going to back out, as you suggested, waiting on Roshan, just forcing VP back with that push.
Yeah, and by forcing them back, this allows Virtus Pro to... It forces them to smoke, because VG Gaming are going to split up and farm out the map a little bit, and I think that VP know that, or they anticipate it, but VG Gaming have the same idea, as they're completely grouped up on the high ground, and they completely sense this is...
Yeah.
They're even pinging out as they're moving.
If no one's pushing out the bottom lane, and they also have that aggressive vision in between the bottom and middle lane, next to the base of VP, they know that VP have just completely disappeared off the map.
Yeah,
but
VG Gaming
want to
take this fight.
Absolutely. To stay on the high ground, Shackle Stun, oh my god, what a long range of one Fenrir! He'll get the save,
the three-man screen!
This she ends with the three-man stun! Winter's Curse on the DK Phobos, but who cares? Burning come forward and just hit the biggest sonic wave of his life, taking out four! DK Phobos to fall as well, and VP just got it utterly obliviated.
I mean, at that point, Virtus Pro were kind of in a desperation area because they knew how far behind they were, so they go for the smoke, but VG Gaming know that as well. They're thinking to themselves, okay, we're so far ahead at this point that Virtus Pro have to do something desperate. Nobody's showing on that bottom lane, nobody's showing in that mid lane, and this is why it's so important to have a hero that can instantly wave clear so that you can move on from target to target and not make it so obvious. But because VP were a little bit too impatient, VG Gaming, they take the high ground in that fight, they're able to get that three-man Slardar crush.
And now VG Gaming, he's going to push into this tier 3, still another 15 seconds until the Gyrocopter's back up. This is looking like a full lane of racks. And BG Gaming can actually just back up and wait for Roshan at their leisure.
Yeah, they're going to take a free Rax. They don't even have to use the Aegis that they don't even have quite yet. And once they grab that, I mean, it's going to be so hard for them to grab.
I like how you're already calling it Vici Gaming's Aegis, because they have so much control, it just seems like there's no chance a VP will actually be able to contest for that Roshan kill.
They're probably still going to try, because they're not scaling in items anymore, and it's not like things are getting any better for them. So you continue to just hope that maybe you'll have a successful fight. But DK Phobos, for example, has completely just been left behind. He's only at 6.4k net worth.
Yeah.
No real items on him that are coming out either. Maybe the BKB, but I don't know if that's game-changing enough, because they simply just don't have damage.
You know, I was going to call it Virtus Pro. It's a do-or-die smoke for them to go into the Roshan pit, but they don't have a smoke. That already happened. They used their last smoke. The next one isn't up for 7 minutes, which means it's even less likely that VP will be able to contest for that Roshan without the surprise advantage.
Yeah, and Burning is probably going to go for the Shivas. He's got the plate mail on him just because the Alchemist already has the AC completed, and there's about to be a heart on Super 2 as he's going to be fully six-slotted.
Item after item just racking in for VG Gaming, and they're just going to wait out Roshan. Virtus Pro obviously have to contest, but how are they going to be able to find their opening 15 seconds? Now Ice making the jump on Illidan here, follow up, FY, and they just get blown up. There goes the carry of VP. VP is still going to try and fight it out, but immediately the Dazzle's going to lose his life. The Orchid controls him. DK Phobos not going to make an escape either. Three down, looking for more. G is going to be the next one caught as Shadowstrike catches him out, tries to go for the TP away. Ice gets the stun in time. That's a fourth down for VP. And now a guaranteed Roshan for VG Gaming, or they may not even go for it. They might as well just push out the bottom lane and try and end this thing.
I think you just continue to push right now. You don't really have to wait for the Roshan just because of how far ahead you are now. And VG Gaming, they're on the Radiant side of the map, but that was pretty much something that VP had to do. You have to take that fight at that point, right, even if you don't have a smoke, because you're just getting further and further behind. With Aegis and Cheese on the side of VG Gaming, there's almost no chance that you win that fight.
Heading on in through the middle lane to go straight to bottom without waiting for that creep wave. Lil, the only one to be able to defend, four staffs himself, does make a resummon, tries to go for the kill on Ice, but Cold Embrace stops that one in a heartbeat. And VG Gaming will claim their second lane Arrax. Virtus Pro, their third lane Arrax will stay intact, but that's only because that tier 2 has yet to be taken in the top lane.
And it looks like VP, I mean, they're still staying in the game despite the fact that they're so far behind. If we just look at the difference in net worth, it has to be near 30k. I'd imagine that the experience is in a similar area.
And Roshan may just be what puts it over the top for VG Gamings. We'll see. Virtus Pro pushing back that bottom lane. They'll never be able to get to Roshan in time with all this minus armor and the damage on Super.
Yeah, I think Virtus Pro, they're probably just... they don't really want to GG quite yet, because you want to fight for that last Rax, but they're probably discussing what's going wrong and what went wrong, despite the fact that they had such a good start. It never really felt like they were able to put too much pressure, and that Roche fight was just so disastrous for them, and they're probably just assessing what went wrong. VP, they're going to make a go of this, though.
Shackle Shot onto Burning, that's going to be a good setup. Maybe they could take away that early Aegis. Nether Strike, Burning? No! The Power Shot snags him. And VP, Illidan actually wants to set this one up onto the ultimate. The ultimate comes out for the Winter Wyvern. DK Phobos can immediately going to be the target, though, as he tried to charge in. Does manage to get the charge off. Still has another strike as well. Bumps back, does manage to push around Super, but Illidan just doesn't have the damage necessary. And G couldn't even get close with Fenrir intercepting the rest of VP, making sure they cannot get uphill into that fight. FNG going to try and hide away that gem, but VG Gaming don't have to worry about kills anymore. They can just go straight for the top lane, and I bet they could even backdoor it with the amount of damage they have now.
Yeah, they don't really care at this point. They understand how far ahead they are, and these fights, it's not like it gets easier over time, right? They lose two fights in a row. The third fight's not going to be any easier for them. But still willing to stay in, going to wait for Illidan to respawn. And that BKB, just at six measly charges now.
Another tier 2 going to fall. Super, even eating through that backdoor protection. Finally, they do have the creep wave here. That'll make things a bit easier for them. By the time they get uphill, though, Gyrocopter will be back. And it looks like he will be even able to... No, it's actually all unreliable gold, so he may not even have buyback with this next life if he dies immediately again.
But Super, he does have buyback. He's just going to continue to hit this. He's got the boost of travel too. Lotus Orb coming onto him too, just in case you could go for the reverse shackle.
Yeah. Lotus Orb, Solar Crest. I mean, Super is just a monster right now.
3,200 health.
Jump in, ice, two-man stun. Illidan's gonna throw out the ultimate as well, but it just does a pittance of damage as VG Gaming just don't seem to be threatened at all by DK, Bulbasaur, Lil. They start trying to go for Fenrir, but a good Winter's Curse holds the rest of EP together, and they will fall together as well. 16-32 is the end score as Virtus Pro finally called GG.
And just what a dominant performance by VG Gaming. Every single time that VP decided to make a move, VG Gaming were completely there. Remember when they went for the smoke on mid? VP, it fails. They instantly group up on VG Gaming's side. They go for the smoke of their own, completely just outplaying them turn to turn.
Yeah, absolutely. Virtus Pro, I mean, they had the early start, though, with the Dryarcopter and everything else. Do you still feel like this is going to be a close series, or VG Gaming, with this display of game number one, just too far?